You are listening to the Antidote to Deception radio program, a ministry of the Global Gospel Power Outreach. And now to the studio and our host, the Wordmaster, Vernon Peters.
Hello, friends, and welcome to our presentation for this evening entitled The Word of the Week. And it's just that. As we continue to be bombarded left and right in our world by different views, different viewpoints, different voices, it is very important that we have a primary voice, the Word of God. And on this broadcast tonight, which, by the way, is the first in a while, and I truly do apologize for that, but God willing, we'll have more on a consistent basis. But tonight, I just wanted to give you a thought concerning how important it is for us to have the Word of God, the Bible, the B-I-B-L-E, as the foundation and principle of our faith and practice, especially as we go forward in this world that we're living in. We'll have a few songs that I'd like to just share to just empower and discharge the atmosphere as we go on. I don't want you to think that I'm throwing stones or attacking anyone particularly, but in preparation for this year's first week of October, which annually I like to set aside for us to focus on the Bible, it's called Bible Week, and this year, definitely, we need to focus, we need to get back to basics, basic instructions before leaving Earth. And so following these items of music, what you will hear is from my heart on this week's episode of the Antidote to Deception radio. May God bless you as you continue to listen to His Word and look forward on the other side of these musical items to a very powerful word that may indeed change your perspective going forward.
Humbled in spirit, broken before your throne, nothing of my will, Lord, just yours, yours alone. Jesus shines all God's majesty, and that is all I want the world to see. Like Jesus, all I want to be is like Jesus. nothing but love, Lord. There is nothing more to seek. Serving as you did, so willingly and so meek, the power of your presence, oh,
came into my heart. I have light in my soul for be so happy as onward I go, since Jesus came into my heart.
Since Jesus
longing just to all is stripped away, and I simply come, longing just to bring a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. You search much deeper within, through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it, when it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus. King of endless word, no one could express how much you deserve. Though I'm weak and poor, all I have is yours, every single breath. I'll bring you more than a song, for a song in itself is not what you have required. Oh no, no, you search much deeper within, through the way things appear,
you're looking into my heart.
Looking in my heart. It's all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it, when it's all about you, all about,
it's all about you,
you, Jesus.
I'm coming back, coming to back, the heart of worship, and it's all about you,
all about you,
all about you, Jesus. I'm sorry, Lord, for the thing I made it, when it's all about you, it's all about you, Jesus.
It's all about you.
How many of us truly, truly believe that it is all about Jesus? Friends, in the next few minutes, I just want to share with you from my heart, especially in light of what's been going on in our world. Please join with me as we have a short word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for just bringing us together again in this fashion and this form. Thank you for blessing us with these items of music, dear Lord, as we prepare just to share this word of the week. I ask your Holy Father to now come and just saturate the hearts of your people with this message that's pertinent for our time, we pray in Jesus' name, amen. Please turn with me in your Bibles to 2 Timothy chapter 3, and we'll pick up from verses 14. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14 to 17. The Apostle Paul, speaking to his young church Timothy, says, "But continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned, and that from a child thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. All scriptures is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works." 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14 to 17. Friends, as you know, here in the United States, this year is an election year, and you are hearing voices left and right. She says this about him, he says that about her, and you're caught in the middle. I want to submit to you that that's exactly the issue, not just here in America, but all over the world, that there are voices that's bombarding us left and right. Eat this, drink that, wear this, wear that, go here, go there, do this, do that, think this, think that. And yet all along, especially for those of us who are believers in the Word of God indeed has given us instructions and corrections that the man and woman of God may be perfect and thoroughly furnished unto all what? Good works. And so as you realize, dear friends, the millions of voices that come at you on a consistent basis, whether it's from your TV, your radio, the internet, mobile devices, as a child of God, I'm asking you to do this. And it's simple this. Tune out the world and tune in the Word. Let the Word of God be your guide. Let it not be any church, any pastor, any voice you hear over the media. Today on my Facebook, I was greeted with this word. And it said, if you are a, and it mentions particular religion, and do not accept the Trinity as it is taught or as it is explained by our church, please remove me from your friend list. Friends, I have no problem, and I will never have a problem in honoring a request like that. The problem that I do have is with the source of the explanation, the church. Not saying that the church cannot be under the guidance of the Holy Spirit and therefore can be correct. But as a Christian, the explanation does not come from what the church says. It comes from what the Bible says. And so therefore, if the Bible's definition of who God is does not mesh up with what the church says God is, then I would rather go by the Bible and the Bible only. Do you hear me? And so therefore, we need to get back to basics. We need to get back to what the Bible says. Many people right now are fearing, especially what they think would happen to America if a certain person were elected. But just the other day, I said to a friend of mine, I looked up into the heavens and I said, God, are you still there? Are you still on the throne of the universe? And friends, I want to let you know something. That should be your response also. Because if you think some man, some woman, some mortal has the power to overrule in your life what God has ordained for you, then you might as well have already packed it in. But my Bible tells me and tells you to continue in those things which you have learned. It says, all scripture is given so that you and I can have authority here in this world to live by. Not what some person standing behind a desk says, whether it be a preacher or a politician, but the pure, unvarnished Word of God. So going forward, dear friends, I want you to look to the Lord. I want the Word of God to be your standard guide. Not what a human says, even though they may be absolutely 100% correct. Back to that by the Bible, Isaiah 8:20, that's the principle. Isaiah 28:9 and 10, that's the principle. Remember these scriptures, record them, write them down, memorize them, and let them be your authority. You will hear many people tell you things that are not true. And if you've been listening to the Antidote to Deception, if you've been following the website, if you've been studying along with me over these past years, you know that I don't tell you to follow me. I point you to the scriptures. I give you the references that you can go by. I don't ever encourage anyone to listen to me. What I want you to do is listen to the word of God. Let that be your conscience, the voice of God speaking to your heart. If what you're doing, if where you're going to worship, if how you see a particular issue in this life, and expert this, pundit that, comes on the media and tells you this is the way for you to believe, this is the way for you to go about things, friends, I do an absolute 360 degree turn and turn to the Word of God. I promise you right now that the strategy is to scare you, to frighten you into submission. There is an agenda in this world, and they want you to believe their way of thinking, their way of doing things. And so they scare you into submission by having you prescribe medications that you don't need, vaccines that you don't need, protection from governments that you don't need. They make you hope and depend on them in one form or the other. And we all buy into this. But the word of God lays there in the dust. Friends, we have a golden opportunity right now to swing the pendulum all the way back to the foundation, back to the Bible. And I encourage you, beloved, to do just that. It's okay to sit and listen to a beautiful message from a pastor, preacher, your minister, whoever teaches you the Word of God. But friends, as I've been saying for always, be noble like a Berean and go back and research for yourself. You don't even have to wait until you go home. You don't even have to wait 2 seconds, because you should have your Bibles with you always. And if you're on the go, you have it. You should, on your mobile phone. And if you don't, I encourage every one of you who has space on your phone that is being occupied by Candy Crush or Angry Birds or whatever latest app is, especially our young people, replace the space with the Word of God. And just as it is fresh on my mind, I want to encourage all of you to join me throughout the month of October as we look at the Word of God. That will be our study and our subject for October. And I encourage you to please visit theantidotetodeception.com to make sure that every day of this coming October that you find yourself studying at least one passage of scripture. Take the time to go through and to revise materials that you have been lacking in. It's very important that the Word of God become fresh again in our hearts. The Bible says, "Thy word have I hid where in my heart that I might not sin against you." The word of the Lord is a lamp to your feet, beloved, that you don't stumble, and a light to your path, that you may know how to go along the right way. When you turn to the left, when you turn to the right, God's word will be dear to you, saying, "This is the way, walk ye in it." Dear to believe. As we go forward, friends, from now on, I challenge you to take up the Word of God as it says. Notice again as we look back in 2 Timothy chapter 3. It says, "And that from a child," speaking of Timothy, and many of us indeed, friends, have been in this condition. "And that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus." All Scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. How about you? Do you need instructions today? Look to the Word of God. Do you need to be reproved? Look to the Word of God. A friend of mine share with me the beautiful words of Psalms 36. And I encourage you, friend, when you get a chance, read Psalms 36. It's a beautiful passage that will break up hard hearts and soften them to the word of God. Friends, right now, in these last 10 or so minutes that we do have, I want to challenge your conventional thinking. Because it is 2016 and it is common to do so, many people trust what they read on Wikipedia, what they see on YouTube, and the latest postings on Facebook. They take that as the gospel. But those of us who truly know what the gospel is, I honestly invite you to please, please, please let that be primary. You know how when you go to your gas station and you put a certain grade of gasoline in your car because that's what the user manual says is best for your car? We call it the BIBLE, and we know what that means. But some wise person has used it as an acronym, Basic Instructions Before Leaving Earth. The Bible, over and over again, from Genesis to Revelation, is chock full of instruction, of information, of things that you need to grow. And by the grace of God, I pray that you take full advantage of these things. My time is almost up for tonight's presentation, but I want to leave you with this thought. This week, it has become very clear to me that many people don't value the Word of God because they don't value those who present the Word of God. Just like we are accustomed to saying that politicians are liars because they are not used to keeping their words once they are elected. The people who profess the name of God have not always lived up to the standard of righteousness, and others have seen their bad example and say, how can you call yourself a Christian when the Bible says this and you do that? Present company included. And I ask you, dear friends, that those of you who profess to know God, let it be your studied aim and constant effort to bow the knee before God. And like one of our songs said, that all I want is to be like Jesus. Just ask God to have the mind of Christ. And that would be our theme for this month of October. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. You will see it posted on our Facebook page at The Antidote to Deception. Go to facebook.com, The Word Master Presents, to sign up if you're not already a member. But that's the thought. And how was the mind of Christ in Christ? By him constantly being in the Word. In fact, that scripture that I quoted to you, Psalms 40, says, Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against you. Actually comes from Jesus. He's the one who says, Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Friends, it is only by studying the Word of God that we can know God. It is only by studying the Word of God that we can be like Him. And so I challenge you right here, right now, to let the Word of God dwell richly in you. Let this mind that was in Christ Jesus be in you right now. And the only way that you can do that is by looking to the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you so much for this time spent speaking from my heart to their heart. As we separate now one from the other, I just ask you to saturate their hearts with the desire to study your word and If they have not found that love that needs to be there for you, I pray, dear God, that they will find it and that it will be found. Continue to bless every person, dear Lord, who has a desire to know you more. This is my prayer in Jesus' precious name.
Visit us online at www.theantidotetodeception.com.